As the business community eyes 2023 as a year that could redeem them from the nightmares of 2022, government says there is light at the end of the tunnel. According to the Permanent Secretary and Secretary to the Treasury, the economy has recovered and is ripe for doing business.
Perceptions about doing business within the economy remain positive, as shown by the Business Tendency Index, which is put together by Bank of Uganda every quarter. And it has remained above the threshold of 50. In other words, fellow Ugandans, the economy of Uganda, despite the challenges we have faced, which we all know, we have over spoken about them, is now showing very good signs of recovery, and we expect that in the next half, the last half of this financial year.
This comes at a time when the Minister of Finance released 6.4 trillion shillings to the various ministries, departments, agencies and local government for expenditures for the third quarter. Speaking to Urban TV exclusively, John Walugembe, the Executive Director of the Federation of Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises, said that the release of funds is good for the business environment.
As I said, it is a stimulant. It helps businesses to move. No? If you were going to a client and all the time, we don't have money. Now they are likely to pay you because now government has released money. So I think that is the positive thing, and we urge all SMEs to ensure that they take advantage of these opportunities. And all other SMEs, if you're not working with government, there's no reason why you're not working with government. Yeah? Find a way of participating in any form of procurement at the local or national level, based on your capacity. If you're a micro business and you can't contract with the central government, at least pick a contract from a local government, see, so that you're able to also take advantage of your resources, because these are our resources.
It is no secret that the economy was hugely affected by external forces like the war in Ukraine and the impact of COVID-19 in China, which disrupted the supply chain to Uganda. Story by Lucius Kasuma for the news.